reading is to the mind what exercise is to the body. Today, I'm excited to share with you one of my favorite Notion book tracker for cultivating a reading habit. This has been instrumental in helping me track my reading time and stay on top of my reading goals. With just a few clicks, the book tracker initiates a new reading session for me, and with another click, it seamlessly logs my progress for each book I am reading. Let's take a quick tour of the layout of this book tracker. At the top of the page, you'll find categorized bookshelves. Here, you can see the number of books and the progress within each category. Now, shifting our focus to the left, you'll find all the key functionalities of this book tracker under the navigation, which we will explore one by one in the following sections. Moving down, you'll find a reading habit tracker where you can set your reading goals for the week. For example, if I aim to read for 3 days this week, I can check in each day after completing my reading session. The tracker automatically calculates my progress towards my weekly goal. Additionally, it generates new records automatically every week. If you ever want to review past habit check-in records, simply click on the All section. Next up is one of the key features of this template, reading time tracking. Through this feature, we can clearly understand how much time we've spent reading today and how long it took to finish a particular book. To start recording, click on the Start Reading button in the Quick Add Chunk. Select the book you're currently reading. When you're done reading, click the Close button under the Reading Records chunk. This allows me to track how much time I've spent reading each book at any given moment. Turning our attention to the left, we have the Reading Overview section. Here, I can intuitively see my progress and completion status for the books I'm currently reading. I can also track how much time I've spent reading this year and how many reading notes I've made. Since any change in each book dynamically affects the data in this overview, it provides a real-time reflection of my reading performance. Moving further down, we have the list of books I'm currently reading. Within this chunk, I can track the time and progress I've spent on each book. By clicking on a book, I can adjust the current page I'm on, and the system automatically calculates the reading progress bar. During my reading journey, if I come across any insights, inspirations, or critical thoughts that I want to jot down, I can click the New Note button to promptly record them in my notebook. All created notes will then appear in the Reading Notes section below. If I feel that a particular book isn't suitable for my current reading journey, I can change its status to Give Up. If I've finished reading, I can change its status to Completed. Additionally, I have the option to rate the book, making it easier for me to review it later. This way, the book will transition from my currently reading list to my completed reading list. To add a new book to my list, I can navigate to the Quick Add chunk and click the New Book button. From there, select the category and the author. When choosing the author, you'll notice a star icon next to the author's name, indicating that I've added this author to my favorites. If I can't find the author in the database, just type their name and add a new one here. If you're reading online, you can also input the link here, making it easier to find the reading link later. I can also add the book cover to make my page more visually appealing. Next, I'll input the total number of pages for this book and record the page I've reached each time I finish a reading session. This way, I won't lose track of where I left off when I come back to it later. Additionally, I can click the New Category button under the Quick Add chunk to add new book categories. The last chunk on the dashboard is the book list. In this chunk, we have three sections. The To Read section can be considered my reading wish list, containing books I haven't started yet, but would like to read in the future. Next is the Completed section. Here, we can see the list of books we've finished reading, along with their ratings and total reading time. I enjoy rereading books because the feelings they evoke can vary at different stages of life. Moving left, here's a neat and tidy quote widget. Every time I open this template, it displays a different random quote for me. Below that are the quotes I've added to my favorites. Returning to the navigation chunk at the top of the page and access to the quotes page. Here, I can click the New Quote button under the Quick Add chunk and fill in the quote and the author. If I want, I can check the favorite box to add this quote to my favorites. I can also drag and drop the quote to add it to my favorites list. The quotes added to the favorites list will appear on our dashboard, reminding us constantly to stay motivated and positive. Returning to the navigation chunk and enter the My Book List page. Here, I can manage each book in more detail. In the All section, I can see the reading status, reading progress, reading notes, reading records, and the rating of each book. Continuing down, here is my reading progress Kanban board. I can adjust and track the reading status of each book. Further down, we have our bookshelf. Here, each book is neatly categorized into the compartments of the bookshelf, just like they would be in a physical bookcase. Let's return once again to the navigation chunk and enter the planner page. Here, I can set up and execute my reading plans. On the right-hand side, you'll find all the books I'm currently reading. By dragging and dropping, I can schedule them for the dates I plan to read them. When the scheduled date arrives, I can see the books I need to read today in the today section. I just need to click on the book, and then click the Start Reading button to begin my reading session. And when the reading session ends, simply click the Close button. Finally, let's navigate to the author page. At the top of this page, you'll find a list of authors I've marked as favorites. As you scroll down, you'll see three different sections. In the All section, a comprehensive list of all authors along with their respective countries. Moving to the Author section, author profiles are displayed in a card-like format, offering insights into each author's background and the number of their books on your book list. Lastly, in the Country section, authors are grouped based on their nationality, providing me with the opportunity to explore authors from different countries. There are many more features on the navigation bar, and I'll leave the exploration to you. I hope you found this video helpful and got you excited to dive into planning your reading adventures. You can click the link below to start your reading journey. Thank you, and happy reading.